For more on the implications of President Duterte's latest pronouncements, we now have on the line Calixto Toti Chiquiamco, the president of the Foundation for Economic Freedom. Good to have you back on, Toti. Welcome to the program.
Good to be here.
So first, is it legal, Toti? What more do we know about the legality of suspending rice imports under the rice tariffication law?
Well, that's the big question. I think that has to be verified if there's a legal basis in the rice tariffication law for the president to suspend rice imports. As I understand it, the president can only raise tariffs but not suspend rice imports. But, you know, if nonetheless, if they still push through with it, I think, though, it would be a big mistake.
Why? Why would that be a big mistake?
Well, first of all, I think it will only reward the rice traders and the rice hoarders who have filled up their warehouses full of rice. Once rice prices go up because of the suspension, they'll be the ones to make a profit and unload. It will not do anything to raise the farm gate rice prices. Secondly, of course, limiting rice imports will hurt 105 million Filipino rice consumers, no? And it will increase the risk of renewed inflation and price increases. Remember, in the past 3 months, inflation has really gone down because of price liberalization. And that has allowed the central bank to reduce interest rates, which have helped businesses and also borrowers. So it would be a big mistake to go back to the previous regime of restricted rice imports. Remember, this is the regime we have had been under for the past 30 years, and it has not increased farmers' incomes, it has not resulted in lower rice prices, etc. So why go back to a failed policy of restricted rice imports?
But the president is seeking a happy balance, Toti, between local farmers trying to make a living and local consumers trying to secure their supply at affordable prices. So how do we address the current imbalance, if you will? What do you propose in the interim?
Well, the only way to correct that imbalance is to increase the productivity of rice farmers. That way it will be a win-win solution. That means lower prices, at the same time higher incomes for farmers. So, suspending rice imports will send a wrong signal to rice farmers that they don't have to become competitive, they don't have to increase rice productivity.
But that's going to be for the long term, increasing farm productivity. What can we do in the interim, in the short term?
I don't think in the short term we can do anything, you know, because you know, the only way we can do it is to do some kind of conditional cash transfer or some kind of an aid subsidy to the rice farmers.
And as you
That's
talk about,
that's the only way to you know, to have only solution on a short-term basis.
On a long-term basis, long-term productivity, as you mentioned, what can we then learn from our neighbors like Vietnam and Thailand?
Well, actually, what we have to do is first promote land consolidation, because we need land consolidation to modernize farming, to apply machinery, fertilizers, new technologies to increase productivity. And secondly, we have to diversify our crops, because certainly for certain marginal rice lands, farmers will not be able to compete with Vietnam and Thailand, who have the natural irrigation of the Mekong River. Remember, rice farming is very water intensive. If you don't have irrigation, it's going to be very hard for you to be able to compete. So I think there should also be a need for some crop diversification.
All right. Well, thank you so much for your views there. Toti Chiquiamco of the Foundation for Economic Freedom on the line.
Okay. Thank you also.